How's it going, everybody? It's been a little while since I saw you, but I'm still Justin Skaggs, and this is still the eLacrosse Question of the Week. Brought to you by Style and Strings and Jim. I've been getting a whole lot of questions about a very simple, very effective style of stringing. You put a U or a V, depending on what part of the country you're from, into the pocket. Now, this isn't to act as a shooting string, but rather a guide. It's just going to be something that guides your ball straight to the center of the channel rather than have it run along the sidewall and mess up your passes. Now, this will not make you an ultimate player. No pocket will. If it could, I'd be playing D1 right now, wouldn't I? But this will give you a little bit better accuracy, and it's so simple I can't believe I haven't done it yet. I did incorporate one into a goalie stick, but this is the main focus of a V. So let's just go ahead. I'm going to sit down. We'll run through it real quick. You guys are going to see this is real easy, real effective. You guys can implement this onto any of your sticks, defense, attack, midi. It's all good.
Now, for good measure, we're going to take a piece of shooting string the size of your elbow and back. Then we're going to hitch it right in the middle of where you want the U shooter to stop. I generally go one diamond below the bottom shooting string. Now, I've been doing this for a while. I find it's easier just to go ahead and weave one piece of the string all the way through and get your set form for your U shooter. Otherwise, you may end up with one side going down one extra diamond. It just gets a little bit confusing. Going through with one string really helps out. As you get down towards the bottom, it's important for me to mention, remember to hitch it into your sidewall. It's the main structural point for the entire pocket, and even though we're not going to pull this thing tight, we do want to make sure that it is, you know, moving with the rest of the pocket. It is a piece of the pocket. Now, when it's all said and done, make sure you still have enough slack on the initial side to tie it off when you're finished. As it looks on the screen, I'm going to wrap the string around the sidewall and start weaving it in through the initial string. I'm coming from the back of the stick to the front on the right-hand side, and then coming back again from the front-hand side of the stick to the back on the left-hand side. I'm going to repeat that process until it's all one uniform string job. Said and done, we're going to tie it off with a trusty square knot. Left over right, right over left, and pull till it's taut. There you go, guys.
Pretty quick way to increase your accuracy. Took about 15 minutes of my time. I don't know what it took out there in TV land yet. I haven't edited it. But it is a real quick, real efficient, great addition to your pocket for middies, offense, everybody. I would suggest that you guys are trying this if you have a little bit of problem with your accuracy. If you don't, just keep it the way it is. Now, if this doesn't help you out, take this V or U shooter out, go back to the wall and start hitting it. Like I said, it's not always your pocket, sometimes it's you. Just saying, I'm sorry. Accuracy is important. Alright guys, stay tuned. Kumar and I are going to be traveling around the country interviewing cool people and showing you guys the latest in innovation in lacrosse. And right now, this is the eLacrosse Question of the Week, and I'm your host, Justin Skaggs. This has been brought to you by Style & Strings and Gym-O-Wax. Take care. Keep laxing.